Welcome to the Campus Solutions 9.2 PUM Image 24 video feature overview. This video will cover the PUM Image 24 overview, financial aid updates, and two features from campus community, fluid drop zones and preferred name search. PUM Image 24 was delivered on February 8th, 2022. There are 202 bug fixes and 14 accessibility bugs included in PUM 24.
For financial aid, we have delivered our annual update to move prior award years to financial aid history. This move includes 2019-2020 ICER, 2019-2020 Profile, 2019-2020 Verification, 2019-2020 INAS. Financial aid delivered a regulatory update to the college financing plan templates for aid year 2022-2023. Updates to both the undergraduate and graduate templates include the addition of the VA Education Benefits section. A new award group for VA Education Benefits has been added to the award group mapping setup for College Financing Plan. We've updated both templates to accommodate other modifications to the form, which include the removal of some award groups and text changes. Be aware that the net price to you value now is the estimated cost of attendance minus total scholarships, grants, and VA education benefits. In partnership with the Financial Aid Advisory Group, we are addressing a concern with the delivered financial aid bind records. We have updated the SQL views in the bind records to eliminate additional effective data logic for enhanced performance. We are delivering this update for financial aid bind records in stages. For more information regarding which bind records were updated in PUM Image 24 and the records targeted for future releases, please visit Knowledge Document ID 279-8878.1 in my Oracle support. As delivered in PUM Image 24 release, we have provided the ability for you to enable the Use 49% override in the Term Information section when creating the R2T4 worksheet. When enabling the Use 49% override, a message will be displayed to inform you that by proceeding, you are confirming that you have previously verified that the student has met the 49% withdrawal exemption as outlined by the Department of Education. When the Use 49% override option is enabled, the system will update the system calculated percent Title IV aid earned to 100%. This updated value will then be leveraged in all the subsequent R2T4 calculations. When using the Review Title IV session page, you can enable the Use 49% override to update the percent Title IV aid earned for period to 100%. When you create the R2T4 worksheet for a student that you previously created the Review Title IV session page for and use the Use 49% override, you will see that the Use 49% override in the Session Information section has been checked and grayed out. When you check the Use Session Calculation Data option, the Use 49% override saved on the Review Title IV session page will be used in the R2T4 calculations within the worksheet. When the Use 49% override is enabled in either the Term Information or the Session Information sections of the Create Worksheet page and the R2T4 calculation is performed, it will remove the ability to override the days and adjustments that can be made as a part of the calculation of the percent of Title IV aid earned.
In PUM Image 24, we have delivered drop zones for the first group of fluid self-service pages. Drop zones are a people tools feature that allows you to add custom content to a delivered page without making a direct customization to the page. Because the custom content is added by configuring the drop zone, the content will persist through any delivered page updates and doesn't require retrofit in the same way as a direct page customization would. Drop zones are one of a group of features, including the page and field configurator, that allow direct page customizations to be replaced by configuration to reduce maintenance effort. The first step to set up drop zones is to define the custom subpages you want to add. This is done in App Designer. You can include fields, tables, grids, or instruction text on your subpage as required. Once you have defined your custom subpages, they can be added to one or more drop zones via a simple configuration component. For more information on creating custom subpages, please refer to Configuring Drop Zones in the People Tools People Books. In PUM Image 24, top and bottom drop zones are added to the personal details, biographic details, and emergency contacts fluid pages, and we'll show an example of adding simple content to the delivered personal details page. For each of the pages, the top drop zone is added below the page title, in this case below personal details, and above the date of birth field. The bottom drop zone is added after the last configured region or field on the page, in this case after the visa permit region. By default, no content is configured for the drop zones, so the zones are hidden on the page. The page display will remain as it was prior to PUM Image 24 until some content is added. To illustrate how drop zones can be used on the personal details page, we created two simple custom subpages, one to display the user's driver's license in the top drop zone, and one to display some simple instruction text in the bottom drop zone. Once you've created your custom subpages, they can be added to drop zones using the Configure Drop Zones component. You can search by component, and if any of the available drop zones have been configured, you can see a list of configured subpages. You can also search by configured subpage, where a custom subpage is being used across different components. The two components with drop zones delivered in PUM Image 24 are shown on the right. For the personal details component, the grid shows the top and bottom zones that have been added to the biographic details and personal details pages. The grid also shows where the drop zones appear in the tab order on the page. The custom subpage is selected from the subpage name lookup, and the changes are saved to complete the configuration. And here is the personal details page, with the subpage that includes driver's license displayed in the top drop zone, and the subpage that includes instruction text in the bottom drop zone. After PUM Image 24, we are planning on delivering more drop zones for fluid pages in Campus Solutions. Please refer to the Using Drop Zones on Fluid Pages section of the Campus Solutions People Books for more details on drop zones and their implementation in Campus Solutions. The top-rated idea in Ideas Lab for Campus Solutions is an enhancement to add consideration of preferred names to person search. In PUM Image 24, we have delivered an enhancement that allows you to optionally configure the Common People search to consider preferred name type records. The Common People search record is used widely across Campus Solutions, including here on Add Update a Person. This search currently only considers primary name type records when the user searches by last name or first name. In PUM Image 24, we have introduced a new configuration option to enhance this search to also include consideration of preferred names. A new Preferred Name Search checkbox is added to the Names Addresses tab in Campus Community Installation. By default, the checkbox is not selected. To include consideration of preferred names in the common search, select the checkbox and save the installation record. To show how the search operates with preferred name search enabled, we're going to search with the last name of O'Leary and the first name beginning with the letter T. Here are four example students with slightly different combinations of primary and preferred name to illustrate how the search behaves. The first student, Terence, has the same last name for primary and preferred, but different first names, Terence and Terry, both starting with T. The second student, Thomas, has identical primary and preferred name, and the first name begins with T. The third student, Anthony, has primary and preferred names that have different values for both last name and first name. The first name for his preferred name, Tony, starts with T. And finally, the fourth student, Theodore, also has primary and preferred name that have different values for both last name and first name. His primary first name starts with a T. Here is our search for last name of O'Leary and first name beginning with T. With preferred name search enabled, the results include rows for matching primary and preferred names. For our first student, Terence, both primary and preferred names match the criteria, and because the first names are different, both are included as separate rows in the search results grid. For our second student, Thomas, both names match, so he is included, but since the names are the same, only one row is included for his primary name. For our third student, Tony, his primary first name is Anthony, and that does not match the criteria. so without the preferred name search enabled, he would not be included. In this case, since preferred name search is enabled, he is included in the results, and his preferred name is displayed. For our final student, Theodore, his primary name matches, but not his preferred name, so he is included with his primary name displayed. In summary, in PUM Image 24, the existing people search used across campus solutions is enhanced to include preferred names. The configuration is optional with a simple checkbox to enable the feature. Once enabled, you can find people by matching to their preferred name as well as their primary name. This concludes the video feature overview. Thank you for joining us.